So in this series of lectures, we're going to talk about motor systems. And I want to draw your attention and remind you of the directional flow of information within the nervous system, whereas afferent is arriving information, and that's when mostly we think of sensory. In this cluster of lectures, we're going to talk about efferent, or exiting information, which is mostly motor. So motor information is information coming from the brain, going through the brainstem and spinal cord, out your spinal nerves, and it's information concerning movement going actually to your skeletal muscles. Motor behaviors or motor actions, we think of the terminology is, you know, action or behavior, involves your entire CNS. It starts in the brain, in the premotor cortex. To motor cortex, it travels through the brainstem all the way down to the spinal cord and then exits via from the spinal cord ventral horn through the ventral roots to the spinal cord or the spinal nerves. I also want you to remember that there are two types of motor information and motor behaviors. There are the visceral efferents that are contained, the visceral efferent motor neurons are contained in the intermediolateral cell column, and those are the they're going to exit with your ventral roots, and they're going to innervate hollow organs like your gut, your heart, your lungs, that kind of stuff. Those behaviors are a little bit harder to quantify, but you do know that you're breathing, and you do know that your heart is beating. The somatic efferent is what we're going to spend most of our time talking about, and those neurons are housed in the ventral horn. And again, those axons exit with the ventral rootlets and join the spinal nerves to distribute in the periphery to all of your muscles. So the take home from this brief introduction is to remember that efferent is motor. I want you to remember which parts of the CNS are involved in motor behaviors. What are the differences then between the somatic and the visceral motor neurons? Think about what they do and where they are. And then, oh, and of course, that leads to right to the last one, which is where are your somatic and visceral motor neurons? If you understand these basic concepts, then you'll be ready for the assessment.